I hope you're well rested from farming the last event, because another one is coming our way. From Neural Sister to a gang member to an adorable rhino, this banner has it all, so let's talk about them. I'm extremely hyped for this event because there's lore involved, and I'm always a sucker for that, but not as much as I'm a sucker for packed event shops. There are plenty of things to buy, so get ready to start farming. This includes a new welfare, Whislash, who's a support guard and happens to be the Neural Girls' aunt. I'll talk about her at a later date though. Shaw's getting an event currency skin and I absolutely love it. Probably one of the cutest skins in the game, and the Ghostbusters-esque vibe of it just makes it better. She's not the only one though. Glaucus and Mayor are also getting Ghostbusters-esque skins, and Phantom's getting one which makes it look like he's the owner of the haunted castle they're cleaning out. Do I have Phantom? No. Will I be buying this skin? Absolutely. But without further ado, let's actually start talking about the new operators.
でも君丈夫そうに見えないぞ。まあいいか。僕はバブル。今のところ部族では一番弱いけど、パパの次ぐらいに強くなれるように訓練してもらうぞ。
Bubble is probably one of the most adoptable units in the entire game. By that, I mean I took a single look at her face and immediately thought, ah, you're my daughter now. Along with Shaw, she's one of the shortest units in the game, only being taller than Durin and Myrtle, whose entire race is characterized by being tiny. But being adorable isn't the only thing she's great at. With her skill 2, Bubble becomes a pretty great meme unit. Just wait to see once I get there. For now, we have to talk about her talent, and there isn't really much to say about it. Whenever she's attacked, she reduces the attacker's attack by 5% for 5 seconds, or 8% at E2. Sadly, I don't believe this stacks with itself. Most enemies have a quicker attack time than 5 whole seconds, but that doesn't mean their attack will keep reducing each time they do so. Although this nice little effect is certainly appreciated. First skill is a pretty basic, simple defender skill. Defense plus 50%, that leads her to have 705 defense at E1 max for 35 seconds, which is much appreciated, but who cares? Because quite frankly, her second skill is much better. It's kind of like a few between Hoshiguma's and Thorns' second skills. She stops attacking and becomes a high priority target for enemies. The thing is, she'll have an 85% defense increase, leading it to be 869, and each time she's attacked, she deals physical damage which is equal to 40% of her defense to the attacker, which is 347. At first, you may look at this and think that isn't much, that's not even an 11% increase to her attack, but when this is in effect, it has no cooldown. Every single time she's attacked, the enemy gets blasted. This is what I mean by she's a great meme unit. It's kind of hard to explain it without actually seeing what goes on, so I'll link one of my favorite videos that showcases this. Just by giving this skill a bump up to M1, the defense to damage percentage is increased to 50, and the defense buff itself raised to 95%. Even at just E2 level 1, that already boosts the damage she'll be doing up to 458. But since you'll probably level her up, at E2 50, this would deal 579 damage. If you live for the memes and want to M3 this, her defense buff goes all the way up to 120%, making her deal 653 damage each time she's attacked. Any other unit who boosts defense is an ideal match to get the most out of her meme potential, the most obvious ones being Ak and Nyan. But for those of us who don't have either of those, it's fine. You can bring along a Bison on his skill 2 for a 25% defense buff, and this event's welfare also boosts defense, with a base of 10% at E1 that goes up to 27% with her skill 1. If you're able to bring along both of these, you'll be raising her defense to 1985, meaning her damage is going all the way up to 992, and that's beautiful, honestly. Bubble is just an adorable, memeable unit, and what more could you really ask for from a rhino daughter?
こんにちは、ドクター。僕はアオスタです。先日は僕たち3人を助けていただき、 ありがとうございました。もしよければ、しばらくここで働かせてください。
Aosta is a unit. I'm not gonna lie, I don't like how this man looks at all. Zero disrespect to the artist, especially since I like some of their other characters they've drawn, and zero disrespect to anyone who has him as a husbando, but this is definitely my least favorite design in the entire game. But I'm not gonna let that get in the way of my opinions on him gameplay-wise. Similar to Executor, he's a boomstick sniper, aka a very small range, but he deals damage to every single enemy within that range, as well as dealing 150% damage to the enemies within the first row. I've seen mixed opinions on this archetype, and I personally don't mind them, although I totally understand if you don't like their range as it can make their placement pretty finicky. Similar to Blue Poison and Thorns, his talent deals an extra little bit of magic damage for the next 3 seconds. It's completely unaffected by if the enemies were in the first or second row of his range. That extra little bit is 12% at E1, draining 69.6 HP every second at E1 max, or 209 in total, and 18% at E2. Using E2 level 1 stats for a more direct comparison, it deals 104.4 damage every second, or 313 in total. There's a bit of a drawback though. This only affects enemies that aren't being blocked, and due to the very nature of his range and placement, that doesn't happen all too often. Although when it does, every single enemy in his range is going to be losing some extra HP, which is fantastic. His first skill boosts both his attack and attack speed, which is pretty good since he's on the slower side with a 2.3 second interval. The attack increases by 34%, leading it to be 777 at E1 max to enemies on the second row and 1165 on the first. The speed increases by 35, allowing him to attack once every 1.7 seconds. This may not seem like too large of an increase, but usually in the span of 35 seconds he'd attack 15 times, while now he can attack 20 times. And honestly, that's pretty good. Skill 2, on the other hand, starts off by doing the exact opposite. His attack interval is increased by 50%, meaning he can now only attack once every 3.45 seconds. Although the attack buffs seemingly make up for it, with a 50% increase, that brings him up to 870. And while that would usually mean the enemies in the front row are receiving damage that would be the equivalent of his attack being raised to 1,305, the effect of his trait is doubled, meaning that the 150% damage is now 300%, the raw numbers as an attack stat being 2,610. Each time he attacks, he'll bind the enemies for 1.2 seconds, meaning they can't move but they can still attack. This bind time goes up to 1.5 seconds at M3, and his attack increase is now 70%. At E250, that brings his attacks on enemies in the second row up to 1,103, and on the first row to 3,309. That honestly sounds great, but don't let yourself be blinded by big numbers. The attack interval increase and shorter skill duration is a huge detriment, as he can only get in a total of 7 attacks at M3. For the sake of a direct comparison, let's say there's a single enemy with zero defense in his range, and it's in the first row. Using the stats from skill 1 at level 7 and him at E1 max, by the time the skill ends, he's done a total of 23,300 damage, while with an M3'd skill 2 at E250, it does a total of 23,163 damage. That isn't even made up by skill 2 having a shorter charge time, because as a matter of fact, it's 11 seconds longer. When I was first doing research on him, I originally planned on saying that these skills are interchangeable, and while they technically are, skill 1 is objectively better. Now, don't get me wrong, I'm not saying Aosta is a bad unit, he has a niche that he fulfills, but unless he's a husbando to you, he really isn't a unit you should prioritize. And if he is, keep in mind that while the big fancy numbers on skill 2 seem better, skill 1 is much more effective.
Kajimi-eshi-no-kishi.コードネームブレミ社員だよお姉ちゃんから噂は聞いてるよ。ドクター、私のことは直接マリアって呼んでくれてもいいからね。
I've always mentioned how I'm a big fan of healing defenders, so the fact that Blemishine also doubles as a DPS unit makes that even better. Her first talent, Sword and Shield, oh wait, wrong Sword and Shield, let me just... there! Her first talent, Sword and Shield, is simple yet incredibly good. All the units who charged their skills by getting attacked now also charge their skills by attacking. The majority of units this benefits are defenders, but even if she's the only one who has a skill that charges like that on the field, it's still fantastic. Her second and third skills are charged this way, so while they'd usually cost 16 or 28 SP, they'll take much less time to charge since in pretty much any situation where she's being attacked, she can also attack. Second talent is quite a unique one because it makes her the only unit currently in game who's able to attack enemies who are deep in slumber. As a matter of fact, she actually prioritizes them and her attack is increased against them. Not gonna go over the numbers right now as it'll be in her stats. If you have a Sora, these two would go fantastically together because of her first skill, which inflicts slumber upon all the enemies in her attack range. Her first skill is the basic healing defender skill, but with an added bonus of dealing damage to an enemy. The healing effect is 120% of her attack, that being 482 at E1 max, and the damage she deals in her next attack is equal to 884 or 1060 against enemies who are asleep. What's pretty great about this is the fact that since it's partially the basic healing defender skill, it has a super short charge time at 5 seconds, and can hold a couple charges. It's kind of a fusion of Gummy and Silver Ash's first skills, which I quite enjoy. Her second skill is a bit different than the usual healing skill. First of all, her attack is increased by 70%, leading it to be 683. All allies within this new range will be healed by 17% of this attack for 10 seconds, being 116 every second, leading to a grand total of 1,161. As well as this, the enemies within her Tal get inflicted with slumber, so when she attacks them, because of her talent and buff from this skill, she'll be hitting them for 819. M3ing this skill brings her buff up to plus 110%. Meaning that at E250, her attack is now 947. The allies are now healed by 20% of that, which is 189.4 every second and 1,894 in total. The unfortunate enemies who were put to sleep once this was activated will be attacked with 1,325 power. This skill costs 12 SP, and its charging time obviously varies depending upon the enemy or enemies who are attacking her. The very least amount of time this would take to charge, I'm talking in a scenario where she's blocking an enemy who isn't even attacking her and she's just attacking it. It would take 14.4 seconds to charge, or 19.2 seconds if it's at level 7 instead of M3. I haven't talked about skill 3 yet, but in my personal opinion, this one is the best for consistent healing. Not only does it have quite a low cost, but it heals quite a bit to quite a few allies. That being said, skill 3 is a bit more damage oriented instead of healing. Her attack is increased by 80%, leading it to be 811, but it also deals an additional 70% magic damage, which is 567. To most enemies, that'd be a total of 1,378 per attack, and to slumbering enemies, it'd be 1,929. On its own, that's pretty great, but it also heals a nearby ally for 80% of her attack, which would be 648 since we're only counting in the original attack boost and not the extra damage that she'll deal. Different than most healing defenders, usually when they have a larger range, it's a multi-target heal, but in this case, she kinda just has a larger amount of allies she could possibly heal. Not complaining at all since the heal is pretty good, and once again, this is her more damage-oriented skill. She also gets an extra 30% defense, raising it up to 694, which is definitely appreciated since at the end of the day, she still is a defender and therefore a tank. M3ing this increases her buffs by quite a bit, her attack bonus being plus 110%, going up to 947, as well as an extra 100% magic damage, leading the total to be 1,894 or 2,641 depending on the enemy's status. She also heals for 100% of her attack, which once again is now 947. Her defense is 854 after a 60% increase, which is also pretty great. The one baddish thing about the skill is that she can't heal herself with it, but considering everything else that it does, that's not much of a problem. Especially since this last lasts half a minute. Skill 3 is a more DPS-oriented skill, Skill 2 is a more healing-oriented one, and Skill 1 is a nice little mesh of both of those things. I feel like all three of these are interchangeable depending upon what you want and need. She's pretty much a complete package who I have no complaints about. That was it for this one. I hope you got some information out of it or just enjoyed the vibes. If you're rolling on this banner, I wish you the absolute best of luck getting who you want. Sadly, I'll have to completely skip out on this one because I really can't afford to roll anymore until Saga comes out, so I'm giving out any possible luck I could have had on it to you guys. The most important thing I want to say though is thank you so much for 3,000 subscribers. That's a ridiculous amount of people, and I truly can't believe that there are that many of you out there who enjoy my content. That being said, if you happen to be one of those new people, or if this is the first video of mine you've watched, my schedule up until the 25th of April is going to be pretty much non-existent since I'm busy with some stuff in the non-gacha world. But if you stick around until then, I can 100% guarantee that both the consistency and quality of my content will go up. That's pretty much all I have to say. Thank you for watching, and for 3K, I'll see you another day.